What is going on with my voice? Yo! Y'all, I'm sorry, man. I went out with my boys a couple days ago. My voice is still fucked up. I'm debating if I should even do this video. Anyways, like I was saying, man, welcome to the video. My name's JJ, if you don't know me. Today, we're just gonna get straight to the point, man. It's gonna be a short, quick little video. Today is finally the day where I get to reveal what it's like driving on my flywheel. How does it feel while I'm driving? Like, do I feel any differences? Or, like, what's my thoughts? You know, first things first, let's get this out the way. Some of y'all that are watching might not even know what a flywheel is. So, just real quick, all a flywheel is just, it's like a rotational mechanical disc. It connects to your crankshaft. When your engine's spinning, all it does is stores the rotational energy and just puts it all out. So, torque, for example. Now, what does that even mean? Like, what does that mean? Like, all right, so, like, think about a potter's wheel, right? You step on the pedal and it spins the whole plate, even though you're stepping on the pedal in intervals, right? But you can let off the pedal and it'll still spin. That's basically what all the flywheels are. It helps the engine get it up moving, and it helps it, you know, idle whenever you're just in that light. You know, just helps it keep it alive, stuff like that. Alright, so now that we got that out the way, what is it like driving with this light-ass flywheel? I'm gonna be honest with you. You know, actually driving with the flywheel isn't all that bad. I thought it was gonna be a lot worse. Still a bitch. Still a pain to drive with. But I thought it was gonna be a lot worse compared to what the Forum. GTR, that was crazy. Basically, just driving with this thing, you can feel the difference. When I first started driving, stalled it. Of course I did. Stalled it immediately. Not gonna even lie. Not gonna bullshit you guys. It's just weird because, you know, with the lightweight flywheel, whenever you go to, you know, do the engaging point with the clutch and the pedal, it's different because with the lightweight, it takes a lot more to get the engine going from a stop. You know, it takes a little bit more energy because, you know, it's lighter. So you kind of have to ride the RPMs up. Like, usually I can get it to around 1500, 1400 pretty smooth. Like, I'm still getting used to it. I've been driving on it for like a month and a half, still getting used to it. The cams in the car, for those of you who don't know, this car is cam. If you haven't heard from the beginning, it's cam. The cams don't help at all because, you know, the cams, your car, it's basically, when you're sitting, it wants to die. Like, it's the engine is starving. So, like, that combined with the lightweight flywheel, it's not fun. So what does it feel like power-wise? Like, do I feel a difference? I feel a difference in accelerating and decelerating and rev maxing. Honestly, decelerating feels the same. Rev maxing feels the same. They say it's a lot harder. Yeah, they say it's a little bit harder because the RPMs fall down. Honestly, it's not that bad at all. I can, like, see, that was pretty much perfect. The real question is do I feel a difference when I am accelerating, when I'm on the gas? To be honest with you, I haven't floored it yet, but I plan on doing it soon, so stay with me here. I haven't gotten all the way on the throttle, but at low speed, say around like 20-30, feels about the same, to be honest. Where I can tell the difference, though, for sure, just by driving this, is when I'm on the freeway, when I'm in like third, fourth, even fifth gear, when I have to get around somebody, it's crazy easy. It's like wow. Like, usually people say you feel a difference going 0 to 100. Like I said, I haven't floored yet, so I don't know. But just on the freeway, just driving, I'm just like, man, like, it's crazy. I can get around cars easily, no problem at all. Not no worries. See if I can get it smooth. Fuck, damn. See, that's the thing about the lightweight flywheel, man. If you miss it, like, if you jump the gun, RPM just fall straight down and you just bog all the way out. Like, it's super boggy. It's a lot more boggier now. Is that gonna work? Is that a word? Boggier? I don't know. Yeah, I mean, if you just miss it, then you're either gonna stall or you're gonna do what I just did. I'm gonna try to do a small first gear pull for y'all. Hold up. It's my first time. I'm a little nervous, not gonna lie. That was new. My first gear is completely useless now. I got no traction. I broke the tires loose all the way to 6 grand, spinning. I was like, holy shit. Second gear, I felt it kick in. I felt it kick in a little bit. Still not too big of a difference from the lower gear. It moved. But I had to let off a little bit. I wasn't all the way on the throttle because I was coming off on traffic pretty quick. But I could feel the difference. I felt the difference, man. It's like, now that's gonna wrap up the video though, man. To sum it up, I love the flywheel. By the way, it's I think it's called a Ram Billet flywheel, something like that. I'll put the link in the description. Got it off AmericanMuscle.com. If you think about picking one up, it was cheap. It's only like $300. Not that bad. Yeah, man. The flywheel's dope. I love it. It takes a little bit to get used to, but you can still daily it. That's another thing. Yeah, man. If y'all got any other questions, hit me up in the comments. You know, me and Jason, we're always in the comments. And, yeah, bro, like, that's it. Fucking day, but you know it's a thunderstorm on the way. You know what I'm saying? You know. All right, that's it. I'm done.